Hello guys, welcome to Tech Gadgets. The new Nokia 3310 has a big problem and it might make you reconsider buying one, because the new Nokia 3310 release date is fast approaching, but there is a information about the features and everything. The revamped Nokia 3310 was one of the biggest hits when it showcased at Mobile World Congress trade show. Nokia revived a classic, its charming little feature phone, the Nokia 3310, and it was first released 17 years ago. The original Nokia 3310 would go on become one of the biggest selling devices for the Finnish technology company. So HMD Global, the hardware company that now sells device under the Nokia brand, has bundled a number of modern additions to the new Nokia 3310 to bring it up to date with rival devices. The overall feature phone now includes a 2 megapixel camera, Bluetooth connectivity, and a overhauled snake game. So the snake game is very famous, as we all know that. But before you rush out to buy one, there is something you should be aware about. Despite having a number of new features, the new 3310 still only runs on a 2G network. Now everyone is shifting to 4G, to 4G VoLTE, and the 5G is also coming in soon. In India also, and in so many countries already 2G network has been demolished and everyone is using 3G. In this era, the Nokia came up with only 2G network, so there is no option to switch to 3G network in that. So according to the specification listed on the Nokia website, the new phone will only function on standard GSM frequencies between 900 MHz and 1800 MHz, and that could prove to be a problem, because a number of countries are looking to switch off their 2G networks in coming years also. It turns out 2G networks are pretty old. It was first used in 1990s and was the first to digitize mobile phones transmission, protecting your data and ensuring that only an intent recipient could receive it. It was only 2G that introduced the ability to send SMS text for the first time. And clearly, demand for these outdated 2G networks has started dwindle in recent years, leading some countries to decommission their 2G infrastructure also, in the effort to create more availability of newer technologies. The 5G is also coming in so many countries. Australian telecom Telstra shut down its 2G network back in December 2016, and Vodafone is also planning to ditch its 2G network by the end of the year. So Australia, Japan, Canada, New Zealand, Switzerland, Netherlands, and so many countries has decommissioned its 2G networks. There are so many countries which are planning to do the same. So the 2017 edition of Nokia 3310 does ship with access to Twitter as well as email, but does not allow to use the popular app, that is WhatsApp. That could prove to be a hassle for Nokia 3310 buyers, because the rugged build quality as well as the month-long standby battery life makes the Nokia 3310 a perfect secondary device. It's not used as a primary device. You can consider this as a secondary device for situation when you likely don't want to be carrying around a smartphone. However, the fact that Nokia 3310 owners are unable to jump into their usual group conversations and send messages to friends using international rates could be a real sticking point for some customers. And WhatsApp, which is owned by Facebook, another significant absence from the messaging app, is comfortably the most popular messaging service in the world, as we all know that. The service now boasts more than 1 billion users. On an average, send some 42 billion messages every day. But if that is not available in this phone, then there is no point. So these are the negative points and disadvantages of Nokia 3310. So think before you buy this mobile. You can buy this as a secondary mobile, not as a primary mobile. So hope that guys you like this video. Please comment and subscribe for my channel for more tech and other related updates. Thank you.